Sometimes we think that electrons appear and disappear, and there's an uncertainty principle about this, but it's not that complicated at all. This is your four helium, this is hydrogen, it spins around, two valence, those two electrons sticking out, it spins around, and therefore it looks like these two electrons make up for an entire shield, but that's because they spin around very quickly. This one spins around a bit more slowly. This is helium. You got your two protons and your two neutrons. It's spinning around, sticking out two electrons, but these two are shielding them from chemical reactions. So that's your helium and your hydrogen. I love those two. Now we got electron shields like this one, 72 valence tops. This is the sixth shield. As you can see, this model is very accurate and it's made out of all these little nucleons. Three quarks, no gluons, just interlocked and they can spin around. So that is a nucleon and every Q-tip represents one of those nucleons. The thing is, the sixth shield, we think electrons pop in and pop out. It's one big thing and there's an uncertainty principle about it. There's nothing uncertain about it at all. It's very simple. This is a proton and compare it with a neutron. A neutron has all the electrons, six electrons, three quarks in a nice fashion. But a proton, there's one of them sticking out. Because of the centripetal forces, one of them sticks out, making this one a proton. The electron is always fixed to the proton. It's not in a free orbit. So now, imagine the ones which are not flagged. The ones flagged cannot turn because of Pauli. So you're left with 72 valence tops with this one. Every Q-tip not flagged represents a proton. And all those protons are turning. And sometimes the electron is inside the atom core. So it's shielded off by the atom. We don't notice it. And somewhere else, someone pops out. So because these electrons sometimes hide within and sometimes are out of the shield, we think it's something magical, like mass appearing and disappearing all the time. But it's not true. It's not a wave. It's a simple mechanism where the electron sometimes is within and sometimes is outside the shield. That's all. Thank you.